Okay, guys, so think about this. Do you feel like you know what you can trust on the internet and social media? So, for instance, do you feel more comfortable clicking on a link or watching a video if tens of thousands of people have already liked it or viewed it? It kind of makes it look like a lot of people checked it out, so maybe it's solid content or legit. Well, in reality, it may not actually be people who clicked that link. A bombshell investigation by the New York Times is making waves this morning because many businesses and personalities on social media are hiring companies, of course, to buy fake Instagram likes and fake YouTube videos. What they do is buy the views, because then they get more views and then they start trending. They get higher in the search results. It leads to actual people clicking on those links. And the more real views you get means you can start making money off of the content or gaining advertisers or selling a product directly. So, of course, it's all designed to get our attention and get our money. Well, it's sneaky and deceptive. This practice is not illegal. Not a comforting thought in this age of people putting out accusations of fake news. We spoke with cybersecurity analyst Alex Hammerstone, who said it may be common practice because it's how many unknown musicians become YouTube stars.
If you talk to kids these days, they don't necessarily watch TV like we did. They tend to be fans of these YouTube stars and other things. So if you're able to promote yourself on there and start getting views and create a what looks like a viewership, a lot of times people will watch things because other people watch them. So people will look for the most viewed things or things with a lot of views, and then they kind of grow from there, become viral or things like that. So you can really kickstart a career, if you're buying these fake views and make it look like you're much more popular than you are.
This year, Twitter started to purge fake accounts, automated accounts, bots. A lot of these were designed just for this purpose. There are companies out there, like one called 500 Views, for example, which can promise unlimited views to a video. In some case, the going rate for 1,000 followers is $10. YouTube says it's taking artificial view counting seriously, but has no way to stop it. So the whole point in telling this story is that just because something has a lot of views, likes, or shares doesn't necessarily mean it's a legit product. You guys know that.
Well, this happens all the time. I mean, even like, you know, for example, like brand ambassadors, a lot of times companies will offer gigs to folks on social media because they have 400,000 followers. Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean they have like real legit people following them. Sometimes those numbers are inflated because they have these bots or a company that's able to sort of inflate the views or following that this person has.
Well, and then the company gets duped too, because the company's paying this person, this influencer, this brand ambassador money in the hopes that these people are gonna buy, but they're not actual people.
That's why I look at engagement more than anything. It's like if you have 500,000 followers and 100 likes on your picture,
like people aren't commenting and communicating with you.
That means your followers are fake, or they don't really like you.
Or they're like, they're like fake friends.
Right, they just don't
like
you.
They're like frenemies.
Then it's on your page.
Well,